Hello students, welcome to class 12 biology. Today we are going to learn biozoology 10th lesson, organisms and population part 2. Today we will be learning about biomes. In this session we will learn about biome and its distribution. So definition of biome we will learn now and its distribution. What is biome, characteristics of biome, and then aquatic biome and terrestrial biome. Okay, so major biomes of the earth can be classified into tundra biome, taiga biome, grassland, alpine biome, and a forest and hot tropical forest and temperate forest. Next, desert biome, we have hot desert and cold desert. Okay, so we shall move on for biome. What is biome? Biomes are large region of the earth that have similar or common vegetation. Vegetation includes same types of plants. Okay, so based on the climatic conditions over there. So it is a larger area which is having same type of vegetation. Why it is having same type of vegetation? Because of the climatic condition. They play a crucial role in sustaining life on the earth. So, one life has to stay on the earth. That is what is called sustenance of life on the earth. Okay, so these areas with the same climatic condition play a major role. They are defined by their soil. Biome are defined by the soil, climate, flora and fauna. As you know, flora include all the plants, fauna include all animals. Next, we are going to learn about characters of biome. So characters, when we are asked to write about the character, you should write the location, geographical position. Okay, so where it is present, away from equator or near to equator, that is what it means. Then what is the climatic condition there, and physiochemical environment, and predominant plant and animal life. So what are the major plants and animals living in that area? Then boundaries. So what is the boundary? That is the surrounding areas of the biome. Okay, so and the boundaries are not generally sharply defined. Okay, so what is transitional zone? Transition or transient zone we have in the case of the grassland and then the forest biome. You suddenly we will not get, if you consider this to be grassland, this to be forest. Okay, suddenly from grassland to forest the transition will not occur. You have the area where we have few grasses, few trees. Okay, few grasses and few trees. Next we will have full forest. Do you follow what I say? First grassland, then the transitional zone including grass and tree. Then only trees like forest. Do you follow? This area is called as the transitional zone. Next we are going to learn about the aquatic biome. As the name indicates, aquatic, it is about the water. 71% of biosphere is occupied by this aquatic biome. And it is a home to millions of aquatic organisms like fishes. And climate of the coastal zone are influenced by the aquatic bodies. Okay, so how far the water is able to withhold the temperature and which is able to, which allows the organisms to flourish in the particular environment. So aquatic biome of earth, fresh water, it can be lakes, ponds, rivers, brackish water. So brackish water means where the marine water and fresh water mixes with each other. They will see the water seems to be very dirty because mixing up of water makes it looks dirty. That is what is called as estuaries, and then wetlands. So land with wet condition, and then marine, as you know, in marine life are coral reefs and pelagic zone and abyssal zone. So pelagic zone, abyssal zone, as we have seen in the case of the pond, surface, column, bottom, reader. That is how the pelagic, that is on the surface of the marine area, and an abyssal zone below the pelagic zone. Okay, these are all the different zones in the aquatic biome. Okay, next we will learn about the terrestrial biome. As you know, large community of plants and animals are present in the terrestrial biome. They include grassland, tundra, desert, tropical rainforest and deciduous and coniferous forest that we will learn in detail now. Terrestrial biome are distinguished primarily by their predominant vegetation, that is major kind of plants and animals living in the environment. They are mainly determined by climate, and which in turn determines the organisms and inhabiting them. Follow inhabiting, that is living in a particular area. These include keystone species. What is keystone species? In particular area, if the organism is not present, it affects the population of another organism. For example, that example, keystone species, if the particular insect is not there, the pollination does not occur in a particular area, which in turn will lose particular plant in the area. That is what is called as keystone species, that we will learn in detail. Then terrestrial biome are the source of food and oxygen, and it acts as a carbon dioxide sink apart from climate regulatory role. So next we will learn about the major biomes on the earth. These names we have already learned. Okay, and you can see the diagram here, how they are classified. Okay, based on their vegetation. Okay, so the from the hot climatic condition to cold climatic condition, the number of organisms reduces once you go for the colder area. Okay, so that is what is mentioned here. Then you can know about the degree of temperature, tropical and temperate. Okay, so more hot is called tropical. Next to that is temperate. As you know, Arctic is very cold. Below that cold level is called as subarctic region. Next, we shall learn about tundra biome. So these biomes we will learn. We will keep learning about the biomes. It is nothing but the names of the animals, names of the plants present in the particular area. You have to by heart. Okay. These are treeless zone, where it includes the northern parts of Asia, Europe and North America. Winters are long and daylight is less. Then summers are short. Okay. So then flora. It includes floras, all plants, dwarf willows, birches, moss, grasses, sedges or the flora, and herbivore is animal, reindeer, arctic hare, musk or ox and lemmings. Then carnivore, arctic fox, arctic wolf and bobcat, snowy owl. Then polar bears live along coastal area. Coming to taiga biome, it is 1300 to 1450 kilometer wide zone south of tundra. Okay, so from tundra these areas are covered. That is what is taiga. Next to tundra will be taiga. This area has long and cold winters. So these areas will have a longer duration of cold season only. Summer temperature will be 21 degrees centigrade to the maximum. That is also a cold condition. And precipitation means raining. It is about 380 to 1000 mm annually. Then flora of the forest, coniferous trees like spruce, fir, pine are present. And a major source is for logging industry. That is nothing but, as you know, the wood industry. Okay, so next we will learn about the animals that is present in the taiga biome, that is migratory herbivores. So it is not constantly being present. Due to the climatic conditions, some herbivores move to the particular area, like moose, elk, deer and reindeer. They migrate to taiga for winter and to the tundra for summer. So the nature of the animal. Common smaller mammals are herbivores, squirrels, snowshoe hare, and predatory pine martens. Okay, so these are the names of the animals, and the carnivores can be timber wolf, grizzly bear, black bear, bobcat, and wolf rains. Okay, next we will learn about grassland biome. We are quite familiar with that grassland biome. It is seen in the temperate and tropical region, and hot summer, cold winters are present, irregular rainfall, and characterized by high winds. Okay, so low irregular rainfall is a factor which makes a difference between temperate deciduous forest and temperate grassland. Okay, so the rainfall makes a difference between the grassland and the forest. Herbivores are antelopes, bison, wild horse, jack rabbit, ground squirrel, and prairie dogs are abundant. Okay, next we will learn about the animals kind of predators, that is carnivore, that is coyotes, fox, hawks, and snake. Then Indian grassland has got the fauna of elephant, gaur, rhino, antelope, flora, purple needle grass, wild oats, foxtail, ray grass, and buffalo grass. Next we will learn about alpine biome. So alpine biome, so sub-snow zone, you call it as the alpine biome, and it is the shrub zone which gradually merges with the timber zone. That is what we said as a transitional zone. The snow zone of Himalaya lies over 5100 meters above the sea level. Okay, alpine zone exists at the height of 3600 meters. Alpine zone of Himalaya is characterized by scarcity of animal group because of the climatic condition. Next we have flora, alpine phasilea, bear grass, bristle cone pine, moss compion, polylepis forest, pygmy, bitterroot, and wild potato. Fauna, many invertebrates of alpine zone are predatory, like they occur in lakes, streams, and ponds. Among fishes, amphibians, and vertebrates are totally lacking the reptilian fauna, and it is very poor. Reptilian fauna is less in number. Next, we are going to learn about forest biome. So, we are familiar with forest also. It is described with large number of trees. Okay, and it includes complex assemblage of different kinds of biotic communities. It can be of tropical forest or temperate forest. We will learn about tropical forest, about the temperature, 25 degree north and 23.5 degree north and 23.5 degree south. Only two seasons are present, that is rainy season and dry season. Winter is absent. So this is important for one mark question. So in tropical forest, winter season is absent. Length of the day is about 12 hours. Average annual temperature ranges between 20 to 25 degrees centigrade. Precipitation, again it is about the rain. So rainfall may exceed above 2000 millimeter. Soil is nutrient poor and it is acidic in nature. Decomposition is rapid and soil are subject to heavy leaching. So because of the decomposition, more in amount of the decomposition occurs at a very fast rate because it is acidic in nature. So it is subject to heavy leaching. Next we have the canopy, tree canopy, that is a arrangement of the trees. So it is multi-layered, continuous, allowing light penetration. Okay, so it is closely present, but it is adjusting itself to receive the sunlight. Flora, it is highly diverse. Okay, so different kinds of organisms are being present. And trees are very tall, 25 to 35 meters height. Okay, and general animals and plants are present in this area. Next, we will learn about types of tropical forest. Based on the seasonal distribution of rainfall, there are four types: evergreen forest, seasonal rainforest, semi-evergreen forest, and moist deciduous forest. So they have the conditions of no dry season, that is evergreen forest, and seasonal rainforest, a short dry period is seen, and a semi evergreen forest, long dry season it shows, and it consists of the deciduous trees and a moist dry deciduous forest, that is monsoon. That length of the dry season increases, further rainfall decreases. That is what is the deciduous forest. Next we will learn about the temperate forest. And this temperate forest is seen in eastern North America and northeastern Asia, western and central Europe. So they have distinct winter and well-defined season, moderate climatic condition, that is 4 to 6 frost-free month is distinguished. An annual temperature can be minus 30 to 30 degrees centigrade, and then rain can be maximum of 1500 millimeter per year. Okay, and the soil is fertile and enriched with decaying litter, and canopy is moderately dense. So canopy is arrangement of the trees. Okay, so next we will learn about the flora. Okay, 3 to 4 species of tree is present per kilometer, and then we have the names of the trees given here and the names of the animals present in this particular area. Next we have types of temperate forest: moist coniferous green broad-leaved forest. Okay, wet winters and dry summers are seen. Dry coniferous forest, dominant higher elevation zones with a low rain. Then mediterranean forest, precipitation concentration in winter can be less than 1000. Okay, so then temperate coniferous forest, mild winter and high annual precipitation, so it can be more than 2000 millimeter per year. Temperate broad leaved rainforest, here we have mild forest free frost free winters is seen, and the precipitation can be more than 1500 millimeter per year, and it is evenly distributed, temperature condition is evenly distributed. Desert biomes cover about 1/5 of the earth's surface, and less than 500 millimeter rain per year is seen, and evaporation rates regularly exceed rainfall rates. Then so much of rain, more than that it is getting evaporated, so it is dry. Soils are coarse in texture, so it cannot withhold the water. Okay, so then sand dunes are common. So sand dunes, as you know, the sand will be arranged in this way, that is how we draw the desert also, that is what is called as sand dune. Then mean annual temperature ranges from 20 to 25 degrees centigrade. Okay, next we will have about the extreme temperature, that is 43.5 to 49 degrees centigrade, and sometimes it can drop up to minus 18 degrees centigrade. Based on the temperature range, they are differentially named as hot desert and then the cold deserts. Okay, so hot desert and cold deserts are the two types of deserts that you should know. Okay, next we will learn about hot desert. So hot deserts, they have a considerable amount of vegetations are being present, and the names of the plants are given. Soil is often abundantly the nutrients are being present, and they don't have much of organic matter. They need only water to become very productive. They can stay inactive and protect a hideways, okay, during hot days. Okay, so the dominant animals of warm deserts are reptiles and sometimes mammals. And these reptiles, they have a spiny tailed lizard and blackbird, white footed fox are present. And insects can be arachnids, and some of the birds are also being present. Okay, next we will go for the cold desert. So cold desert, snowfall is seen, and it is very high also, and it is seen in the area of Antarctic, Greenland and near Arctic realm parts of USA part and Western Asia, Ladakh region of India. And they have short, moist, moderately warm summer. So summer season is very short. Okay, and then mean temperature can be minus 2 to 4, maximum 4 degrees centigrade during winter, and during summer it can be 21 degrees to 26 degrees centigrade. Okay, next is about the rain. So the rain can range from 150 to 250 millimeter per year. Winter receives quite a bit of snow. Okay, the soil is heavy, silty and salty. So silty is, it is not attaching with one another. Okay, so it is loose, that is what silty and salty, based on the content present, salty content. Then fauna, the names of the animals are given here. Next we will have about whatever we have learned so far is about the biome and its distribution. What is biome and what are the characteristics of biomes? Aquatic biome we have learned about the freshwater and marine water, and terrestrial biome, and they are differentially calculated based on the temperature availability, and we have learned about flora and fauna of this area. Students, please copy down these points as notes. It will be easier for you to learn than reading from the book. Thank you, students.